Hi friends, today I discuss inverse proportion. Today I discuss inverse proportion. As in name, inverse is present. Inverse means in opposite ratio. Inverse means in opposite ratio. In opposite ratio. Now, if I take one quantity which is increased by some ratio or some factor, then other quantity decreased by same factor. Then other quantity decreased by same factor. This relation or expression is called x and y in x and y in indirect proportion. Indirect proportions. Let's take an example. If anyone, let's I take a man Abhishek. If I take Abhishek goes from home to school, So the Abhishek goes from home to school by taking different medium. First he take walking and running, cycling or by car. These different transport system, he goes from home to school. If you see these two quantity, first is speed and second in time taken from home to school. The first quantity is speed and second in time. By walking, speed is 3 km per hour. So the time taken is 30 minutes. If I increase the time or if I increase the speed 6 km per hour, then the time is 15 minutes. In same manner, cycling speed is 9 and time taken is 10 minutes, and by car speed is 45, then time taken is 2 minutes. If you check or if you clearly observe this situation, then from first situation to second situation, speed is 2 times and the time is half. In first situation 30 minutes, in second situation 15 minutes. Again, if I take in third situation by cycling, then from first situation speed is 3 times, then time decreases 1/3 or 1/3. If you take fourth situation in which speed increases by 15 times, then in fourth situation time is decreased by 1/15 ratio. So you check that this example, if I increase one quantity by some ratio, then other quantity is decreased by same ratio. This type problem is called, or we can say in this example, these two quantities, first speed of vehicle and second time taken by Abhishek from home to school, these both these quantities are in inverse proportion or in inverse proportion. So by this method you identify this problem or any example for inverse proportion. Now I learn how to solve this type of inverse proportion problems in next page. Now I take an example to understand how I solve inverse proportion problems. So the example is 6 pipes are required to fill a tank in 1 hour 20 minutes. And how long will it take if only 5 pipes of same types are used? So first thing I check this problem is for inverse proportion or not. 6 pipe filling time 1 hour 20 minutes. If I decrease the number of pipe, then time will increase. So one quantity is decreased and other quantity is increased. So this problem is for inverse proportion. Now first I create a form or table. First quantity is number of pipes. And second quantity is time in minutes. So in first situation, number of pipes is 6 and time in minutes. First, one more thing, I again repeat the thing, these both quantities or a same quantity in both situations are in same unit. So the time in first unit is in unit in 1 hour 20 minutes. So I convert 1 hour 20 minutes in minutes. So 1 hour equal to 60 minutes and 20 minutes extra is available. So the total time is 80 minutes. So the total time in first situation is 80 minutes. In second situation, number of pipe decreases, which is equal to 5, from 6 to 5. Now in problem, time is asking to fill same 6-5 pipes. Now I take time in minutes. In second situation is x. Now how I solve this type of problem? So the multiplication of these two quantity. Now the multiplication of these two quantity are same in both situation or same in all situation. So in first situation, multiplication of number of pipes into time in minutes, which is equal to number of pipes in second situation multiplied by time, which is assumed as x. Now solve this mathematical expression. X equal to 6 into 80 by 5. Now solve this. 5 cancels 80 by 16 times. Now multiply 6 into 16, which is equal to 96 minutes. This is your required answer. And in problem, if answer required in hour, then this 96 minutes convert in hour and minute. This is equal to 1 hour 36 minutes. 1 hour 36 minutes. So I hope you understand this example. Now I take one more example to understand whole concept of indirect proportion in next page. Now I take one more example, which is stated as Or the statement of example is 15 workers can build a wall in 48 hours. How many workers will be required to do the same work in 30 hours? This is the worker time problem or work and time problem. If you decrease the time, then you increase the workers. If you increase the workers, then decrease the time. So this problem is for indirect proportion. Now first I create a table or form a table between two variables. The first variable is number of hour, and the second variable is number of workers. So I form a table between two variables which is connect in indirect proportion. Now fill the table. Number of hours in first situation is 48 hours, and by 48 hours 15 workers are required. Now in the second situation I have 30 hours and I find the number of workers which is required to do the same work in 30 hours. I assume the number of workers which is equal to X. Previously starting solution to this example, I find these two quantities are in indirect proportion. So again repeat the same procedure which is discussed in previous example. Just multiply these two quantities, 48 into 15 and equal to 30 into X. 48 into 15 I again fill the table. When the number of hours is 14, the number of workers is 15, and when number of hours is 30, then required number of workers. Now again same procedure, repeat the same procedure, just multiply two variables which is equal to 48 into 15 equal to 30 into X. Now I find the value of X. So X equal to 48 into 15 by 30. Just solve this expression, 15 cut 30 by 2 times, and now 58 by 2 which is equal to 24. So this is the required answer. For 30 hours do the same work, 24 workers are required. So this is the required answer. So I hope you understand the whole concept of indirect proportion with two examples which are discussed in this video. So please download the Scholar Learning app, and if you already download this, then enjoy learning. Thanks for watching this video.